It is the entrepreneur, not government, not politicians, that will save the fabric, the households in this country. If you've ever looked up the word economics, economics 800 years ago was really talking about how to manage a household. This is the problem with this country. The information, the education, what they have been told, 300 million people in the wealthiest country on the planet, 76% of everyone you know lives paycheck to paycheck. Did you know that? 7.6 people out of every 10 people you know, 10 people that you're a family member with are living paycheck to paycheck in the richest country on the planet. How can that be? Are they all stupid? Can't be that. Or were they made stupid? Or do they have the wrong information or the wrong knowledge? Is it possible that salespeople, for instance, over 80% of salespeople don't hit a target? Why? Are they stupid? I don't think so. You know what I think? I think they have the wrong information. I think the way we sold people, the way we educated people years ago is the problem. Look, if you don't have money in your bank account, it is not because you spent too much, and it is not because of debt. My mother is struggling with insurance money. She's trying to get three boys through school and take care of two daughters, right? That's what most of America's trying. They're trying to manage everything. Oh, I'm trying to get it done. I gotta clip the coupons. I gotta save my money. Because she didn't know how to bring money in. Nobody has a debt problem and nobody has a spending problem. They got an income problem. America has an income problem. Look, look, as long as you're a good person, money will solve a lot of problems. It might not make you happy, but we ain't talking, this ain't the happy convention. How many of you need more money? And there's nothing wrong with money, particularly if you have a noble product. In fact, if you have a noble product and a noble service, you should be paid money. Unless something's wrong with you. And maybe something is wrong with you. Is there a possibility that there's something wrong with you? That the people that raised you and the schools you went to gave you knowledge that was incorrect. How many of you were taught this? Money doesn't grow on trees. But they didn't tell you where it came from. Did they tell you where it came from? My daddy's like, money don't grow on trees. But where'd it come from? Look, we print more money in this country than we plant trees. There's no shortage of money, except in your mind. That's why you set targets based on what other people. The middle class in America does not exist anymore, folks. You can call it the middle. You could call it whatever you want to call it. Politicians call it the middle class because if they didn't say there was a middle class, there would be civil unrest. This is the reality in this country, okay? My mom was brought up to clip coupons, save money, protect the money, conserve. Sooner or later, you run out of money. Would you agree? And if you don't run out of money, you end up being very old. How many of you know that guy? He dies. He's your uncle. He died at 89 and you found out he had a $1.2 million and his whole life he acted like a miser. He was putting it away. That's not freedom. That's a slave. That's a $1 million slave. Spend your entire life. Why? Because he didn't want to create income, so he tried to conserve it.